Cotswold Wildlife Park in the merry month of May, I paid the man the money and went in to spend the day. Straightway to the pet's corner I turned my eager feet to go and see the rabbits and give them something to eat. As I approached the hutches, I was alarmed to see a crowd of little yobbos hollering with glee. I crept up quiet behind them and weighed the scene up quick and saw them poke the rabbits, pat them with a stick. "Get off, you little devils," I shouted in their ear. "Don't you poke them rabbits, that's not why they are here." I must have really scared them. In seconds they were gone, and feeling I had done some good, I carried on along. Till, up beside the parrot's cage, I stood to view the scene. Oh, they was lovely parrots, beautiful, blue and green. In and out of the nest box, they was really having fun, squawking out and flying about, all except for one. One poor old puffed-up parrot clung grimly to his perch, and as the wind blew frontwards, backwards he would lurch, one foot up in his feathers, abandoned by the rest. He sat there, plainly dying, his head upon his chest. Well, I walked on down the pathway and I stroked a nanny goat, but the thought of parrots dying brought a lump to my throat. I could no longer stand it, and to the office I fled. Politely I began, "Excuse me, your parrot's nearly dead." Well, me and the curator, in urgent leaps and bounds, with a bottle of parrot cure, dashed across the grounds. The dust blew up around us as we reached the parrot's pen, and the curator, he turned to me saying, "Which one is it then?" You know what I'm going to say. He was not there at all. Well, at least not where I left him. No, he flew from wall to wall. As brightly as a button did he squawk and jump and leap. The curator was very kind, saying, "I expect he was asleep." But I was humiliated as I stood before the wire. The curator went back to put his feet up by the fire. So I let the parrot settle, and after a short search, I found a stick the yobbos had and poked him off his perch.